So the whole challenge probably is then to find a new operating model.
Correct.
To balance new and old.
Yeah.
And in that context, I guess the notion of micro enterprises was launched, right?
About 2 years ago within Fujitsu for Western Europe, which is we launched as a pilot within the group for 7 countries. So Belgium, Netherlands, Luxembourg, Spain, France, Portugal, Italy. We launched a concept of micro enterprises based on inspired by a book called Zone to Win. And essentially what we're trying to do is we try to empower people, give them freedom and to have enterprises within the company that acts a bit like startups. My ambition or my goal would be at a certain moment to launch a lot of new micro enterprises as well. And we started from a very technology oriented base, but maybe the next micro enterprise might be around sustainability or around other areas of the business.
What keeps you awake at night?
Well, I think the biggest challenge is the speed for me. The speed and how fast we can scale, how fast we can actually create new capabilities and new micro enterprises. Because even if I said I think we did a fairly good job, but we're 2 years in the making, and for me, most of the micro enterprises, they kind of they scaled. I think what we're trying to figure out now is how can we have decisions and gates without losing too much of the freedom, where we can actually either decide to stop something or to scale. Even between the micro enterprises, there are learnings. So there might be not all micro enterprises exist in every country. But for example, ServiceNow, they might share experiences or references with other countries to kind of help each other. And for me, definitely it's a success. Because I think the way we see that people are now empowered and that there's colleagues leading the micro enterprises who are now with a very entrepreneurial spirit going to the market, recruiting people, hiring people, but also and it's not just a marketing gimmick, but I also feel in the market that people are willing to join Fujitsu because they're intrigued by the concept of the micro enterprises. When I have conversations with, like I said, CFOs and CEOs, it immediately clicks. And they say, yes, we're working on this, working sustainable finance. We're investing in CFO I was talking to the other day who was working in the Port of Antwerp. They're investing heavily in solar panels because they need to be CO2 neutral. Otherwise, they're not going to win any tenders anymore to do transportation. When I talk to colleagues from IT, even enterprise architects, we're struggling to make the leap. But I think at a certain moment, just like anything that ripples down from the CEO or the CFO, I think we're going to have to adapt. And even from a digital perspective, we're gonna need to come up with solutions in order to make our companies more competitive.
Today, we talk about agile leadership. Then from a very high level, what does that actually entail concretely? Why would we now say we need to be agile leaders, where in the past maybe it hasn't been too much of an issue?
I think to answer your question, we don't, at least as leaders, I don't think we have a choice. We need to attract the right people, trust that we attract those and really empower those to do what they're good at. And I think it was Steve Jobs at a similar moment said, I'm not going to attract intelligent people and tell them what to do. I'm going to hire intelligent people so they can tell me what to do.